This short video shows conversion from RGB565 color format to RGB666 I implemented in my graphic library for the ILI display using TouchGFX. You will see here how I implemented the frame conversion from RGB565, which is the color coding available in TouchGFX, closest to RGB666 used by some version of ILI9488 SPI display driver. Then, we will see the impact to the performance due to the real-time conversion and the longer dataset to transmit. Comparing time to draw over the display board ILI9488 version 2.0, which uses RGB565, to the version 1.0, using RGB666. Then, I will show you how to set the touch device calibration, as it seems by the message I received that these displays could have many different touch sensor configurations. Next, I will propose you another simple help to fix displays errors due to the wrong configuration. As we have already seen in the previous video about TouchGFX, among the color format directly handled by this package, we have the availability of RGB565. These allow us to easily integrate displays like ST7735 or ILI9341. But referring to the datasheet of ILI9488, it seems that this driver does not allow RGB565 on SPI communication, handling only RGB666. Anyway, we have seen also that the board market version 2.0 can handle this color format, and we use them in TouchGFX. Now, after implementing the TouchGFX integration, I added to my library the software conversion from RGB565 to 666, in order to let working with TouchGFX every version of the ILI9488 board. The conversion can be done only in real time, every time TouchGFX sends a frame to draw. We will set TouchGFX to send frames in RGB565, and the library will convert them in RGB666, requested by the display driver. Referring to the datasheets, the two formats on SPI communication have this structure. RGB565 needs to byte per pixel, set in color this way. RGB666 needs 3 bytes, so the library performs this operation, adding a 0 to the lower bit of red and blue byte. As I said, this conversion is performed while data is transferred from TouchGFX to the display, affecting the drawing performance. Moreover, needing more bytes per pixel, RGB666 will need a longer time on SPI communication. To test the global performance of the two color format in TouchGFX, I use the same program we have already seen in the previous video, and enabling the key repeat feature. I measure the time needed to draw the number from 1 to 100 over the display. Here are the results. As you can see, the difference is relevant, but the display board version 1 still performs well, provided probably that you don't need heavy graphic tasks, such as showing heavy animation or videos using TouchGFX. I've read that someone says that using TouchGFX with this library, touch sensor seems to be not working, without any reply to the touch from TouchGFX. Supposing that the project and the hardware also are well configured, there is a possibility that you need to calibrate the touch sensor. But what is a sensor calibration? This type of touch displays are made of two parts: the graphic display and the touch sensor. The touch sensor is a transparent module glued over the graphic display. When you touch the display, It is detected by the sensor driver as a changing in the register value of a display, detecting this way also the touch position. More information about that is available in my previous videos. Let's say here just that the values returned by the sensor need to be converted to their corresponding display pixel position. This is done through a linear conversion, and defining the parameters values of this conversion is the object of the calibration. The set of these parameters is registered in the file touchxpt2046.h, and the values you see in the downloaded file are based on the display I own. And I can tell you that all the display I have of the same type, ST7735, ILI9348, ILI9488 version 1 and version 2, each type uses the same calibration values. But I said I was not able to find the complete documentation about these boards. So it is possible that different boards, coming for instance from different production lots, can have different touch sensor characteristics, needing different calibrations. First of all, we have to be sure that we have a calibration problem. I mean that the project and the hardware are correctly set and the microcontroller detects a touch. That can be easily done this way. Run your TouchGFX project in debug mode, setting a breakpoint inside the callback function of a touch interrupt. Touching the display, you should trigger the breakpoint. That means that interrupt was detected. Ok, remove this breakpoint and set a new breakpoint into the TouchGFX sample touch function. Proceed running in debug mode, touch the display. If the program stops, means that all is working fine. Touch was detected, TouchGFX was activated, and it is reading the position. Now, if proceeding the run, nothing happens on TouchGFX, it is possible that you have to calibrate the display. Here I have a TouchGFX project based on an ILI9341. Trying to compiling and running it, we see it seems working, but not responding to touch. Let's assume we already run the program in debug mode and we saw that touch is detected and handled by TouchGFX. So now let's create a new project using the same configuration. We will use the option Create a new project from an existing configuration file. And we will browse our directories, selecting the configuration file of a not responding TouchGFX project. Give a name to the new project. We will run it in direct handling, so we have to disable TouchGFX. Keep unchanged all the other configuration parameters. Install the library, and let me go faster here, as you already saw the installation in the other videos. Set up the library parameters, as I said, for direct handling. Set up the main function. Display.h file help us indicating the functions to call for the display initialization. copy the suggested calls in the main function. Here, before the main loop. Now, in the main loop, call the function test drawing and run it. Touching display, you should see a white cross right under the touch. That's not so here. We have to set the calibration. Change the main loop and call the function touch test calibration. That function needs you enable printf on float values. OK. Run the program and follow the instruction on display. At the end of the calibration process, the display will show the parameters to set in TouchXPT2046.h file. Open it, go to the calibration parameters section, and set the parameters values. Do not forget the orientation requested. That is the sensor orientation, and it is not related to the graphics you are developing. OK, go back to the main loop and call again touch test drawing. Run it. Now you will see the white cross correctly moving together with the touch position. Yes, it works. So now we will go back to the TouchGFX project and update the calibration parameters. Run the project and hopefully it works. Another really simple problem I saw is to correctly set the display orientation. This is another TouchGFX project using ILI9341. Here display is horizontal. Let me set the background. And move it to the back. OK. Save it and generate the code. Now, trying to run the project. We have this result. As you can see, display is trying to show it vertical. That because the display initialization was wrong. Back to the project, open the main function, and in the display initialization function, rotate of 90 degrees the orientation. Run the program. and the problem is fixed. Good. As always, I hope this video was useful, or at least interesting. See you to the next one. Bye.